talking to someone wrong to you. Good morning, and welcome to the Manna to Live By, one day at a time, 5-minute devotionals. Today is May 25th. Today's reading is from Matthew 18:15. Go, and tell him his fault, between you and him alone. Someone has done or said something which has offended you or bothered you in some way. The Bible says to go and tell him his fault, but you don't want to do it. It's too difficult. So, you start brooding about it. You begin rehearsing what he has done, how he was utterly in the wrong. When you should be working, your mind is going over all the details, and your gastric juices become sulphurous. When you should be sleeping, you resurrect the unpleasant incident, and the pressure builds up in the boiler. The Bible says to go and tell him his fault, but you just can't face up to it. You try to think of some way in which you can get the message across to him anonymously. Or you hope that something will happen to shame him for what he has done. It doesn't happen. You know what you ought to do, but you dread the trauma of a face-to-face confrontation. By this time, the ordeal is harming you a lot more than it is harming him. People can tell by your glum appearance that something is bothering you. When they talk to you, your mind is off in another hemisphere. Your work suffers because you are preoccupied. In general, you are too distracted to be effective. And the Bible still says, go and tell him his fault between you and him alone. By a tremendous display of willpower, you have refrained from talking to anyone else about it, but, finally, the pressure becomes unbearable. You break down and tell one person, just for his prayer fellowship, of course. Instead of giving you the expected sympathy, he says, why don't you go and talk to the one who has offended you? That does it. You decide to bite the bullet. After rehearsing your speech, you obey the word by telling him his fault. He takes it surprisingly well, is sorry that it has happened, and asks your forgiveness. The interview is terminated by prayer. As you walk away, a great load is lifted from your shoulders. Your stomach quits churning, and your metabolism returns to normal. You kind of hate yourself for not having had the sense to obey the scriptures more promptly.
Let's pray. Heavenly Father, forgive me for my unwillingness, many a times, to take your word seriously. And I pray, Father, that I might be given a willing heart to obey the scriptures more promptly. In Jesus' name, I pray. Amen.
Talking to someone wrong to you.
Today's devotional, originally written by William MacDonald. Adapted and developed as Manna to Live By, 5-Minute Devotionals, for YouTube, by John Benjamin. For previous day's devotionals, please click the channel link given in the description box below. Thank you, and to God be the glory.